Assalamu alaikum everybody, this is me Ahmed Hayan Al Sbahi from Faculty of Engineering Technology. We will present in this video module 3, logic gates and integration. Why logic gates, why integration? Because actually the microcontroller, which is our course target, is actually an integrated circuit. It's integrated from gates. What are gates? Gates are devices that use the binary numbers to represent some data. In this module, you are going to understand the basic logic gates. Mainly speak about, there are a lot of gates actually. We will speak mainly about the basic of them, which are inverter and OR. Then we are going to speak about the fixed function logic and programmable logic. What is the difference between programmable logic and fixed logic? This actually make you understand what is inside the microcontroller. So basically, what is a logic gate? As I said, a logic gate is a device, is an electronic circuit that used to perform logic operation. These gates are devices, electronic devices, and the logic is like represented by true and false. True and false is 0 and 1. So that's why binary is representing logics. 0 and 1 representing true and false. Electronics, we are speaking about electronics, so that means we are speaking about 0 for 0 volt, and 1 is 5 volt. Now, the three basic gates are AND, OR, and NOT. The AND is represented by this shape, the OR is represented by this shape, and NOT is represented by the inverter shape. So, we speak about them by one, just very quickly. So, the inverter is like perform the Boolean NOT. So, if we have input A and output X, so if the input is low, 0, false, the output is high, true. If the input is high, 1, the output is low. Okay, so the NOT operation is actually the complement, which is speaking about it last time. And it's like used, represent using in Boolean algebra, it's we use the bar to represent NOT. So X is NOT A, okay? If we have a waveform like this, if 0, the output will be 1. When it changes to 1, the output will change to 0. So this is the input, 0 change to 1, 1 change to 0. Actually, in microcontroller, we will use the time waveform. Moving to the next gate is AND gate. The AND gate produces high output when all inputs are high. So if we have all inputs are high, the output will be high. Otherwise, it will be 0. So, to represent this in the truth table, so 0 and 0 is 0. 0 and 1, 0. 1 and 0, 0. Only if we have 1 and 1, we will get the output as 1. Okay? So, M is represented by multiplication or dot. So, X is A and B. Or we can remove the dot. So, it's X. The output X is A, B. The next gate is the OR. So the OR gate produce high output if any input is high. So if we have one of them is 1, the output will be 1. Okay, so if we have 0, 0, in this case we will have 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, and 1, 1, 1. What does this mean? I mean, in all the gates, the same. If we apply 5 volt here, 5 volt here, the output will be 5 volt. If you apply 0 volt here, 0 volt here, we'll get the 0 volt. For OR, 0, 1 or 1, 0, we'll get 1. Going back to AND, only if we have 5 volt, 5 volt, we'll get here 5 volt. Okay? Now, as I said, we will use the time wave. So, actually, it's represented like this. So, these all zeros. So for the OR, if we have 1 or 1, the output is 1. 0 or 1, the output is 1. 0 or 0, the output changed from 1 to 0. And for T4, time 4, 1 or 0, it's 1, and so on. So usually we represent data in the time diagram, okay? So these basic gates, why we are studying them? Because actually these basic gates actually is integrated inside the integrated circuit. So this type of gate is called the fixed function logic. Okay, so we have some circuits which represent fixed function logic. So it will always operate the same. If the input is 0, 0 and we have OR gate, so the output will be always 0. So two major fixed function logic families, we have TTL and CMOS. So this is the technology of manufacturing them. There is a third technology called BiCMOS, and all of them actually is like they are using the transistor or the semiconductors to build gates. So these are the circuits that you find in the market. So they are circuit for variety of gates. As we speak in the first lecture, we have different levels of integration. We have the small scale integration, medium scale integration, large scale, and very large scale integration. When we speak about microcontroller, microprocessor, we are speaking about very large scale integration. When we speak about memory chips, we are speaking about large scale integration. If we speak about decoders, adders, like logic circuits, it's like medium scale integration, and small scale integration is the normal gates. The concept of programming microcontroller. So to program a microcontroller, actually we use the concept of programmable logic. So let's see this circuit. If we have three ends, and now as you see, this connection is connecting B bar here. This connection is connecting B here. So if I want to change the input, I can remove these connections. So now here, by this connection, now this gate is taking only A and B. So the output is A and B. This gate is taking only A bar and B. So it's A bar B, means not A and B. And if you're taking this gate, it's taking A and not B. So A and B bar. Now, when we write a program, what we do, as I will explain later, we actually upload a program. That means we upload 0 and 1s to a special memory called the program memory. So if we replace these physical connections by a memory, a RAM memory, so now if we have 1 here, that means connect. If we have 0, it's not connect. Okay? So SRAM have 1, mean connect. If have 0, not connect. So what to connect, what not to connect, is decided according to the programming. So this is the basic of everything. So this is the end of like concepts. This is not related really to microcontroller. In next module, we will speak about the microcontrollers. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope you enjoy reading these references. See you in next video. Wassalamu alaikum.